Merry Christmas, apple season. So I'm going to be dehydrating apples, and I have washed them and dried them, and the next phase is to slice them up, but then they'll go in my lovely dehydrator. I will get many of them dehydrated for the holidays. Our red delicious apple. Here is my food dehydrator. You can see that I have some trays of apples dehydrating, and close that back up. This is my work area where I'm actually working. These are the empty trays that I'll be putting new sliced apples on. This is my moulin, my slicing apparatus, and the little device that I use when I get down to the very nub so I don't cut my fingers off. I use this metal measuring spoon to core the apple after I've sliced it. And I use this little paring knife for my apples. Okay. What I'm doing is preparing apples for the dehydrator. The first thing I do is take the stem out of the apple because it doesn't slice too well. So I'm going to have a moulin slicer, which actually it's pretty easy. I just set the apple now. I haven't cored these apples in advance, so it's slicing through the core. When I get down to the very tip of the apple, I use the handle. So now I have all these nice slices already cut, many of which I can just stick into the lemon juice and then throw them onto the dehydrating plate. Some I want to trim out the center, and so I use this little measuring spoon to just press around the core portion of the apple and pop it out, resulting in the core portion being removed. Flipping them in this little bowl of lemon juice, arrange the apple slices on the tray. Now I have almost a full tray of apples. Making these apples is easy and fun and a great way to take advantage of the fresh apple crop that is out there, and to have really excellent tasting snacks. Low calorie, great nutrition. What could be simpler or better? Placing them on the tray to dehydrate. The moulin that I use, I use the thick slice setting, which really gives me about a quarter inch thickness of apple. The slice is about a quarter of an inch thick. And that dries to a very nice paper thin slice when it's dehydrated. Washing the apples with a lemon water wash, laying them out on the dehydrating tray. I'll have 9 trays. That's the maximum number of trays for my dehydrator. I'll get back to you when the dehydrator's full. Here we are, an hour later, and all the apples are cut and in the dehydrator. All that's left is the cleanup. In the lovely dehydrator, we now have 9 sheets of apples dehydrating. That will take about 24 hours for them to dry at 114. I will update you when the apples are dried, finished product. Ho, 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 Merry Christmas. Here we are, the final apples. When the trays are dried, you end up with dried apples. Just place them in airtight containers so that they will stay dried until you want them. But they're great snacks, and I love them.